Ellie Mitchell. I am the director of the Maryland School Time Network and also a Baltimore City taxpayer, a member of Baltimore Education Coalition. This budget cycle could possibly be a play called Much Ado About 4.2. To sum this amount, it's not worth holding up the city budget for, but to the 3,000 marchés in our city, this is a big thing. I know you guys did a lot of work to negotiate on this, and I appreciate that, but your jobs are not done yet. We are very concerned about the cuts that were proposed, particularly around libraries. It doesn't make sense to cut libraries to fund after-school programs. We also are so concerned about our friends with Experience Corps and the University of Maryland Extension. In fact, it would be nice if maybe sometime they pass legislation so we never, ever, ever have to have that conversation again. Because these are treasures in our city that should just be part of the deal. And then last but not least, there are $2.8 million that are at question around the Baltimore City Public Schools budget. They can ill be afforded to not be given to them at this point. And there are technicalities, of course, about why that 2.8 isn't included in the budget this year. But the legislator's intent was $10 million over last year's investment. And we haven't finished that yet. So with that, I will just say that I know you have a lot more work to do. We appreciate the fact that you take the time to do that. And that there is, whatever we can do out here as advocates, we will raise our hands if we can do.
Maryland, I'm also co-chair of Baltimore Education Coalition. First, I want to thank you for your strong support for the youth and the 4.2 million. We understand that there's some issues with that, and I won't repeat what Ellie Mitchell had said, but we are behind any fixes that will take away from youth, and also supporting Experience Corps 4-H and daycare programs. I want to talk about the issue of the 2.8 million and the 10 million. So we understand that there is a need to come in, and I heard in committee yesterday that this body of council is going to wait to hear direction from the AG's office. And that's great, but we wanted to make sure that you understood our position on this as well. And I'll leave you a copy of the letter that we sent to the mayor, as well as the language in the state budget. The state budget says that $10 million must be given above the FY16 appropriation. So if you look at the simple language, the appropriation includes MOE and the other things that's given to city schools, including that 2.8. That's also the intention of the legislature, because we were trying to fill the $25 million gap in state funding that we saw in the governor's proposed budget. It wasn't because the governor tried to cut education from Baltimore City, it was because we lost enrollment and the city's wealth has grown. So as a result, we saw a $25 million reduction in state funding. The coalition worked hard. We went to Annapolis, we turned out hundreds of people, and the governor came through with filling in a little more than half of that $25 million, $12.7 million in the supplemental budget. The legislature then included language in the budget to require Baltimore City to include that extra $10 million, and it's because of that whole $25 million loss. So we want to make sure that understood. And